We're doing a three-part video series on how to architect, build, and optimize an email drip sequence. We've already covered architecture in our previous video, and now we're going to cover how to actually build it.
In this one, we're talking about building your email sequence. This is an example of an inbound email sequence. The first email that goes out is a welcome email. So this is an introduction to the personality. Maybe you want to put a video in here where they're now introduced to your product, service, platform, subscription, whatever it is that you're offering, welcoming them into your ecosystem. You're trying to make a personal connection with somebody here to begin the relationship. The next email will depend upon the product or service you're offering. In our case, it's a SaaS software. So what we do is offer some information about setup, how to get started using the product or service, the steps that someone would take when they're just getting into your ecosystem. Email number three, we're jumping into some use cases. These use case emails are extremely valuable if you're able to connect to your audience member and they find themselves saying, well, that's exactly the use case I wanted. Then you're going to connect with them on a very personal level. Our version of this is how to use Dubb in Gmail. That is a real life example. We provide a screen recording, how to actually use the Gmail integration with Dubb. It shows the buttons, it shows the screen, the interface, everything. These use case videos, there's gonna be more than one of these in your drip sequence, and they're gonna have different purposes for each. The next use case video is maybe gonna be something that most people hadn't considered. So if your product or service has like a secondary purpose, that's also a very valuable use case to detail because it can show that your product or service has some range, has some things people hadn't considered. Another valuable opportunity to connect directly with your audience. The next email in the sequence, this is typically where we would have some type of testimonial. This is an opportunity to tell a story. You can either have the testimonial be directly from the customer themselves, like a video testimonial, which you can capture with Dubb, or it could be like a case study, a link to a PDF or a web page, a landing page where the case study is. The whole purpose of this is to tell a story, to have a narrative of someone succeeding with your product or service. And that creates a very human connection. This does not have to be limited to this number of steps, this number of emails. We actually recommend that your drip sequence does not ever end. You want to continue delivering content to people until they either have bought, and even after buying, they will be enrolled in a different or, you know, continuing drip sequence.
We use our email number drip sequence generator. So we just shake it up, and it actually shows us the exact number that we should have. In this case, it says 12. And that's the number of emails we're going to do in our next campaign.
This would be one of the final emails in this initial drip sequence, and this goes to an offering or a promotion. So this is the opportunity for you to actually ask for the sale. This is where you want someone to take action. So you can offer something like a discount, a promotion, create a sense of fear of missing out, a sense of scarcity, and a sense of value. Receive this, and then now hopefully they can become a customer, which would put them into a different drip sequence. There's gonna be much more detail that actually goes into each of these emails. Things like personalization, unsubscribe links, social links, you really have to put a lot of work into each of these emails. They need to be branded, they need to look good, and they need to have all the appropriate links inside of them. So if someone wants to take action from the very first email, they should have that ability. They should have some kind of link or resource that they can access through any of these emails, because some people are ready to jump the gun. We're gonna actually jump into a screen demonstration of how you can use Dubb to build your email drip sequence.
We're gonna show how you can use the automations feature to build out an email sequence in your workflows. So this starts on the dashboard. We're gonna start here with this email option. So we're gonna have to first create the email that we can then incorporate into our workflows and email sequences. So make sure that you're actually under the automation tab. So campaign emails are separate from automation emails. Emails created under the campaign tab will not be usable in automation. So be sure you're clicking this email button to create an email for the automation feature. Click the new button. We're just gonna create this one. It's gonna be a test two. And then we would select the video we want to include in the email. Make sure you designate your from name, from email, and subject line. Subject lines are very important. Don't miss out on that. And we're going to click the save and continue button. And this is where you can actually construct the email itself. So you can include something for your introduction, whether that's just an intro statement saying, hey, check out this video, anything you want here. And this is the video placeholder itself. So this is where the video will actually go. We do offer some personalization tokens. So if you want to include a first name or anything like that, first name, last name, and email, we can include by using the tokens here. And then at the end of the email, you'll have a place for your email signature or a closing statement, or anything you want to include at the bottom of your emails, you can do so there. click save and continue, and then we'll actually have a preview of the email itself. So there's an intro, the body of the email, which will show up as an animated preview, and then an email signature or whatever you've included in your closing of your email, and then the unsubscribe. So go ahead and click save and close, and now this email is ready to use in a workflow. So back on the dashboard underneath the automations tab, click workflows, and we're going to create a new workflow. So we're going to name this one test 3, and then we're going to, there's different types of triggers. So currently there is tag added as a trigger type. We will be developing additional triggers based off of video and email engagement. So stay tuned for additional triggers. There are also conditions. So there's two different conditions. Includes any of will mean that if you add tags here, a recipient just has to have one of those tags and they will be included here. Whereas if you select includes all of, the contact would have to have all of the tags in order to meet the criteria. So just be sure you select the appropriate condition. We're going to use this test tag 3. Click save and continue. And now we're going to actually start building the workflow. So the first step is to add an action. And so we're going to create a campaign, send a campaign. And so this first step is to send a campaign. We're going to select the campaign, which is the email we just created. So we're going to select that, submit. And then now we can add an additional step. So maybe we want to add a delay of, let's just say 2 days. And then now we submit that and we can add an additional step because we want to add additional emails into this sequence. So for the sake of this video, we'll build out a 2-email sequence. And so we would add, after we added the delay, we would now click send campaign. And we don't have another test email to use, but you will have your library of emails available to choose from there. So click the test, click submit. And so now we have a workflow built that will send this campaign, send this test 2 email. Then it will delay 2 days, and then it will send a second test. You can add as many steps here as you need, so we do recommend having a nice built-out workflow delivering all the content you need. So next step is to actually launch the campaign itself. So this switch here is very important. This trigger makes sure, or this makes sure that they can only be triggered once. So you don't want to send the same person the same email more than one time, and this trigger will ensure that that action doesn't take place. So be sure that, I mean, unless there are certain emails that need to be sent more than once, there are circumstances where that's the case. But for the most part, you will likely want to make sure the same person isn't sent the same email twice. Now, when we're ready to, we want to turn this workflow on. This switch will make sure that this workflow is now active. There's also a spam policy agreement here. You're agreeing that there is no spam, that you are sending these emails to opted-in people, and just make sure that you are being coherent with our no spam policy. Go ahead and click the save and close button. And now this campaign is ready to go. So if I want to send someone into this workflow, all I would have to do is go to my contacts and I would select the contact that I want to add into this workflow. And I will actually add the tag that I would enroll them in to enroll them in the campaign. So I would click the contact here, add tags, and then enter the tag that I assigned to that campaign. So if I choose test tag 3, it will now enroll that contact into the workflow that I have created, which is that 2-email sequence. So now that the contact is enrolled into the campaign, it will send them a series of emails, whatever you've designated in the workflow. We will have additional triggers and things coming to workflows. So if you have any additional questions, please reach out to chat support, email support, and good luck.
Stay tuned for part 3, where we talk about how to optimize your workflow and your email drip sequence. Make sure you subscribe to get the next video in the sequence, part 3.